हेलो।
हेलो।
हाँ जी जी मिस, शैल वी स्टार्ट?
ओके ओके सर।
ओके,
वेरी वार्म गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल। आई एम चिंजू पावलोस, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग, यूनिवर्सल इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज वल्लीवट्टम इनवाइट्स यू टू द थर्ड इंटरनेशनल वेबिनार सीरीज ऑन न्यू ट्रेंड्स इन कंप्यूटर साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग। थैंक यू ऑल फॉर जॉइनिंग अस फॉर टुडेस वेबिनार। Today, we are going to present the topic, Introduction to Data Science, Machine Learning, and Artificial Intelligence. The presenter of the topic will be Mr. Sajin Madhavan. Sajin Madhavan, a data scientist at Wipro Technologies, Bengaluru, working on building a bot which classifies sentences based on sentiment analysis. He is the founder of Condor360.net, an online platform for data enthusiasts to post their questions and get verified answers from experts. And also, he's a mentor at Great Learning and Upgrade, covering wide range of topics from data science to IoT, blockchain, etc. He conducts workshops on wide range of technologies and life skills. So just a little housekeeping before we get started. If you have any questions during the presentation, please type them into the question box in your Zoom, or you have the option of raise hand in control panel for asking your doubts. And please remind that we will also have time for questions at the end. I request all the participants joined through YouTube Live to fill their feedback form that we have sent in your YouTube chat box. It will be considered as your attendance sheet. Now, I turn the time over to our respected HOD, Sanal Kumar TS. Please, sir.
Okay, thank you, Chinju. Good morning, all. So this is a proud moment for Department of Computer Science and Engineering. So I just welcome our beloved principal, Dr. Jose K. Jacob, our presenter of data mining, artificial intelligence, webinar resource person, Mr. Sajin Madhav, and all the participants who joined in today's session. Okay, thank you.
Okay, now I will invite our respected principal, Dr. Jose K. Jacob. Please, sir.
Good morning. Good morning, all. Good morning, Mr. Sanal. Mr. Sajin Madhavan. My dear colleagues and my dear students. I'm very happy that Department of Computer Science is organizing a webinar series. So I'm sure that this type of activities will give a will transform you into new era, that is post-COVID era. So you'll get a clear concept what to do and what are the activities to be done, etc. And I wish all success to this program. And on behalf of University Engineering College, I thank Mr. Sajin Madhavan for your valuable time.
Thank you so much, sir. Okay, my pleasure.
Okay, proceed. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Now it's time to start. So with immense respect, I'm handovering to respected presenter, Sajin Madhavan. Please, sir.
Thank you so much, Chinju ma'am. Thank you so much, Sanal sir. And thank you so much, Dr. Joseph sir. Thank you so much for having me here on Universal Engineering College. Thank you so much for that. I'm really grateful for the opportunity that you have given me. And over to you, all the guys who has been in this, you know, from the students of Universal Engineering College, the Young Minds of India, and also the people who are joined through YouTube. So a very warm, a cool good morning to one and all present here. So I hope this webinar will be a wonderful session for all of you guys to have a different dimension of your thinking, as well as I'll try to put some, you know, things into your head which will make you to think on some way or other. So it's like a career transition for you guys. So without wasting any time, let me start the webinar. So anybody can confirm whether my audio and video is clear. So if that is perfectly fine, we can start it. So could anybody confirm on that?
Yes, sir. Start. It's all clear.
Yeah. Thank you. Yeah. Perfect. Thank you. Thank you so much. So the main purpose of doing this webinar is for two things. First, there is a story behind this. So this is my first webinar that I'm conducting. So there is a story behind this, why I am doing it as a webinar for college students, and why I have selected this particular stream or why this particular topic for doing a webinar. So first, let me tell you the story that, you know, that has given me an idea to start this webinar. So basically, I am a LinkedIn content creator. So I used to post articles related to data science and artificial intelligence and machine learning as well as deep learning. Those articles, I'll be posting it every day on LinkedIn. So it's been like I have been posting it around for a month. So one of my friends startup has approached me stating that they needed a data scientist with an experience of 1 to 2 years for their organization. So what I did is like I posted that in my LinkedIn post stating that we need a data scientist for opening. So basically LinkedIn is like a job portal. Many people see that it's called as a professional social network. So what I did is like I went and posted over there and I got many resumes over my email. So me and my friend started filtering out, and as it was like 1 to 2 years of experience, I have got around 450 plus resumes, out of which 200 are from students. And these 200 resumes, I took it out, I started reading these resumes one by one. And to my surprise, it was like they were applying it for internship opportunities. And most of these students were from IITs and NITs. And I was like, so quite surprised, okay, I have posted a vacancy for 1 to 2 years of experience, but people who are from NITs and IITs and NITs who are in third year and fourth year, they have given their resumes to apply for internship. So it was almost related to machine learning, deep learning, and artificial intelligence as a thought struck me. So these guys have learned these concepts and they have started doing it practically. And these guys have started implementing it practically, and they just wanted to get into an industry with whatever they have learned. So what I did is like I went to my cousin who is studying in one of the engineering colleges. So I went and asked him like, how do you know, how far you're, how well you know about this technology? So I told him, he knows the basic stuff. So, and again, I went back to one of my sisters. She said the same thing. So I felt a little bit of gap between these two institutions, IITs and NITs. So it's not like, so I had a feeling like why should NITs and IITs people should always get success in their life? So fill a gap between these guys so that people from these colleges also get know about, because we have talented young people who are sitting there and watching me and hearing me. I know you guys are also like really talented, equal to IITs and NITs people, and you should also have that equal opportunity to get into this role, right? This data science role. First of all, this data science is a buzzword that is created. So everybody will be knowing about this data science, artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning, all this stuff. It's like a buzzword. So, but there are many people they'll get started by studying statistics, probability, mathematics, but they'll not be having a right direction of going through, because it's like riding a bike at night time without a headlight. So you will be going somewhere and you will be hitting somewhere. So that's not a good idea. So data science is like an ocean. So you need a mentor, someone who guides you in the right path. So it's really important to have a mentor in the field of data science. So basically the purpose of this webinar is to fill, I wanted you guys to understand what is this concepts. I'll give you an introductory session about this. so that you will be able to know what it is exactly, how it is done, what are the industry relevant jobs that is available. We all know that this, due to this COVID situation, a lot of people has been laid off from many companies, and placement opportunities not going in a very good way. So, but having the right skills, having the right kind of technology with you in hand will really boost you to get into companies, very, very, very good companies. So, without wasting any time, I'll start off this webinar with the presentation that I've prepared. So, I'll keep it short. I'll keep it very short. I want this webinar to be a two-way session so that now I shouldn't only talk. You should also, should talk and, get to know more about this. And we will start it right away, right? So let me share you the screen. So everybody can see my screen now. I'll minimize this. Okay, perfect. Okay, so before getting into the webinar, I just wanted to know, like, how many of you guys are aware about this topic? So what is machine learning? What is deep learning? What is artificial intelligence and all these stuff? We know these are the buzzwords that is created. So what is this exactly? Can somebody tell me, some volunteers, what is this exactly? What do you understand by these terms? Anybody can speak up. Any students? Guys? Guys, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, perfect. So I guess nobody is interested to talk. Okay, fine, no issues. So this machine learning, deep learning, and artificial intelligence, it's a technology that has been evolving throughout past a decade, from the year of 2010. Till the year of 2020, right now, it's been like there has been a tremendous growth in this industry. So why there is a tremendous growth in the industry? Why there are a lot of job openings that is going on? Why does people want to invest a lot of money into this sector? So all of these questions should arise in your mind, right? So it's completely like somebody is disturbing the screen. Please don't do that. So all of now, if you could see, the technology has been rising in such a way that almost all of your data is getting captured every time, right? So actually, to be true, we can say like 90% of your data is captured. Whatever the data, when you are browsing your phone, the data is captured. When you are traveling, your data is captured. So almost every industry captures the data. This live streaming, this YouTube is capturing the data. And there are a lot of YouTube contents. There are gigabytes, petabytes, exabytes of data is getting captured each and every moment across the world. So people started thinking, okay, what can we do with this data? So business people, what they did is like they got the data. They changed it in such a way that they have integrated mathematics, statistics, some kind of business applications into it. And they begin to find out some observations from it. So that is how it all came in. So instead of five people thinking and doing it and taking a decision, they built an algorithm and they made it a machine to understand that, and they allowed the machine to predict it. And surprisingly, out of these five people, the prediction that was made by the machine was more accurate. So that is how this evolution came in. So, I'll tell you some of the examples. Like, so everybody is using Flipkart and Amazon, right? So there is a Big Billion Day, and Amazon, we have Great Indian Shopping Festival, right? So have you guys thought, like, why a particular date has been fixed for Big Billion Day? For example, say June 8 or July 20 or some dates. Why these companies, big branded companies, are fixing a date like this? So is it like they are randomly fixing it, or they are just giving it a luck shot? So what do you guys think? Is it just like that, or I want somebody to speak up, please. Any students? Okay, I'm not getting any response
Sajin,
from the students.
Sajin, actually, all the participants are muted. And they can communicate through only question answer session. Okay, you can proceed.
Okay, sir. Thank you for the information, sir. Yeah, perfect. So, guys, there is some kind of calculations that has been calculated for fixing these dates. So, based upon the past data, sales data, based upon the number of informations that they have gathered, they'll be taking, suppose, on the date of July 16, they are fixing a date for Big Billion Day in Flipkart. So this date is particularly fixed on the basis of the dates, the sales that has been done, how many products have been purchased. They'll be taking a particular data, right? They'll be calculating everything. They'll be doing some mathematical computation things, and they will be predicting a date in such a way that on which date, if you select, the sales will boost up. So that is done by using a machine learning algorithm. Similarly, we use Swiggy, we use Zomato. So we'll order the foods, and it will show a map. The delivery guy will be taking that particular food will be taken from that particular hotel to our home, right? So that particular route. So how that particular route has to be designed, that is done by a machine learning algorithm, right? And some other applications include like your object detection. So I'm giving a photo. I'm giving you 100 photos of mixture of dogs and cats. And I want you to, classify them based on dogs and cats. Some pictures like, if I'm giving you 10,000 pictures of dogs and cats combined together, if a human is starting to separate it on the basis of like one cat, one dog, one cat, one dog. So he'll be taking a lot of time to do that. But a deep learning model can do that. So if a machine can understand the stuffs, what a human being can do, a machine can understand that. And if it can do, that is called as machine learning, right? So some of the applications of machine learning, I'll show some of the applications of machine learning. Yeah. So these are a few applications of machine learning. Your chatbots. So when you log on to some websites, if you log on to some websites, there will be a pop-up window that is coming up. Everybody would have used IRCTC website, right? So there will be bottom left, there will be a window coming up saying, hi, something like that. So chatbots basically are built using machine learning models. Your Google Assistant, your Siri, your Alexa, all are based upon deep learning models. On back of that, it's a black box model. On back of that, it runs a deep learning model. So based upon the inputs that you give to the data, inputs that you give to the, that component, it will take your input, it processes in such a way, and it matches to the output that it should give, and it will give you the output. So all this is working on the basis of your machine learning, deep learning, and artificial intelligence. Your gaming. Everybody would be, almost 90% of the kids will be playing PUBG. So inside PUBG, there is a technology called as reinforcement learning. That is a part of your deep learning, right? Next one is space exploration, self-driven cars. Self-driven cars, Tesla. Tesla is a, Tesla company. Everybody would have heard about Tesla, right? Tesla is a biggest, company founded by Mr. Elon Musk. And it's been like a very rapidly growing company. And they have launched rockets into space and all. So they are building self-driven cars. Self-driven cars is completely based upon deep learning, guys. Completely is based upon deep learning. How on the headlight they would have fixed a camera. That camera will be capturing what is in front of that car. It will capture all the images. It will process. It will decide whether an object is there at the front or not. As per the decision, it will turn its steering accordingly. It will accelerate, it will brake, or everything. So that is also done using deep learning. Your face recognition. You are tagging, you are uploading a photo in Facebook. Automatically, it will show your friend's name in a square box, right? You guys would have observed it. So that it is nothing but a deep learning model. Again, a machine learning model is running behind that. It's called a neural network. So again, a machine learning model runs behind that, and it will automatically detect your friend's face. So that is done using machine learning. NLP. NLP is nothing but natural language processing. Natural language processing, I'll tell you a simple example. You go type in Google. If you are typing something, it will give you an auto suggestion, right? So auto suggestion is based on the history of searching that you have done, right? So that is nothing but NLP. NLP is called as natural language processing. What a human being, what a language of human being does, a computer can predict it. So that is called as an NLP. Object detection is nothing but detecting an object. As I told you in the self-driven cars, whether an object is in front of you, if it is in front of you, an operation will be taken on according to that, right? Recommendation system. One of the biggest application of machine learning, guys, recommendation system. Recommendation system is basically nothing but you go to Flipkart. I mean, that best example is Amazon. You go to Amazon, you purchase a product, you scroll to the bottom of the screen, and at the bottom of the screen, you will be seeing a message. People who bought this has also bought this, right? You would have observed that. So that is nothing but recommendation system. Behind the recommendation system, it is nothing but a machine learning model, right? All these things, if you take this data science industry is applied across almost every industry, whichever industry you take, if it is movie industry, if it is logistics, if it is travel, if it is social media, if it is data security, finance, gaming, astronomy, healthcare, transport, agriculture, e-commerce, entertainment, whichever industry you take, it has been, you know, applied across almost all the industries. The main reason behind is two things. One is we have all the data. We are collecting a lot of data. With that data, we are converting that into a useful form. And second thing, these machine learning models are evolving and developing in such a way that the predictions that is done by a human being is much, much, much better. I mean, predictions done by a computer is much, much better than a prediction done by a human being, right? And, matrimony sales also work on the basis of your machine learning, because I came to know about it recently. So based upon the profiles that get matched, you know, it will show you again the recommendation system, right? So these are some of the applications of machine learning, guys, right? So I guess these are the applications. I mean, these are some of the, you know, important areas that has been covered. Other than this, there are many more applications that has been used. But if I go into that, again, it will take a lot of time, and I don't want to get into that. So these are the real-time applications. Quite interesting, right? Okay, so now let us understand what is this data sciences. And what is data and what is data science? So as I told you, every data is captured. Every data of you is captured. All the data are stored under one place, called as in a database container or something. So people started thinking, okay, we are collecting the data. We have started collecting the data. We should be changing in something that it could be beneficial for others. So business people started integrating with all the statistic concepts, mathematical concepts, probability concepts, and they converted into some techniques that made a very good business decisions. So that is how it all grown up. So that is how the data industry has grown so much. From the year of 2010, it has grown like very rapidly into the year of 2020. So there were multiple openings that has been, even during the COVID situation, guys, I recently went across Naukri. So there are, day before yesterday, there were around 7,000 openings still opened. Industries wanted people who are relevant in data science industry. There are still 7,000 job openings. And I was surprised to see that no other job openings were there for any other fields. During this COVID situation, if data science field has a lot of openings, yes, that there is a need for data people. So that is why I have selected this topic for you guys, so that you guys can learn, and once you get passed out of your college, you will be ready for an industry taken. The industry should be observed to ready to observe you guys. So basically, this webinar is for you guys. Fantastic. Okay, so let us understand machine learning. What is machine learning? What is deep learning? What is artificial intelligence? And we'll get on to data science. So without seeing the PPT, I'll tell you what machine learning is. Machine learning is just like us in the sense, when we are trying to learn something new, what we do, we just go read it, right? We go read it. We will try to understand the concept behind it. We'll try to understand that in a very good way and try to make that into our head. and then we'll, you know, revise it. But once revising, we'll make some mistakes. So what we will do, again, we'll go back to the answer, we'll correct that, and again, we'll write that, and we'll correct that mistake. So this is what a machine learning model does. A machine learning model, we give data to the machine. The machine will understand the patterns and structures from the data. And with the patterns and structures of the data, we have some machine learning algorithms that is developed. With this algorithms, it will predict some stuffs, right? Suppose I want to predict I'll tell you a real-time scenario. I want to predict a house price in a particular area. So if I want to predict a house which is at Guruvayur, right? So I will be given all the details, such as what is the square feet of that house, what are the number, how many number of bedrooms is there, what is the distance between that house, from that house to the highway, how many number of hospitals is nearby, how many number of schools is nearby, what is the quality of education that is provided in those schools, and all those stuff which is relevant to this particular data, right? I will take that data, I'll put it onto my machine, I will do some pattern check. Based upon the pattern, I'll build a model, I'll build a linear regression model, and I will predict the price to that particular home. And all these predictions are done by the numbers that is given on these data, the input data that I've told you, like number of bedrooms, the number of square feet, the number of hospitals that is nearby, distance from college, I mean, distance from your home to the highway, the college, and all those stuff. So basically, what we're doing is we are making the machine to understand the concepts behind that, and we are allowing them to predict in such a way that the prediction always goes right, and that is always taken into business, and it always gets into correct way. So that is what your machine learning is. So the definition of machine learning is, ML is making machines to learn, to predict, to classify, to cluster, to recommend. As simple as that, right? So I spoke about prediction. Classification is nothing but classifying the sentences. What I do is, like, I classify the sentences. But what if I say that what I am currently doing on my role, you guys, it's quite complicated. It may get confuse you. So I don't want to get into that part. So it will classify. Classify in the sense, take 52 pack of cards, right? We will be separating 13, 13, 13, 13 into four, shapes we have, right? Similarly, that is what your classification is, separating it. And clustering is the process of clustering or grouping. Like, how many members of this thing should be grouped? How many members of this thing should be grouped? How many members of this thing should be grouped? This is your clustering process. And recommendation is nothing but what I told you regarding the Amazon. A person who bought this also have bought this. So that is called your recommendation system. So all this is done by machine learning algorithms. So we have various algorithms called as linear regression, logistic regression, decision trees, random forest, neural network, support vector machines. Many algorithms is there. Based upon the data, based upon the industry, we will be taking the data and we will be running that models. And all these models will be, all these models are constructed with mathematics running behind it. It's completely mathematics, guys. It's completely mathematics. The integration and the derivatives that you have learned on your 11th standard, no? All this has been packed upon into a software, and it has been launched into Python and R. So Python and R is the main two software packages that is used here, right? So that is about machine learning. Fine, good with it? Okay. Moving on to the next one, deep learning. So deep learning is a part of our machine learning. Deep learning is nothing but it's an extension of machine learning. It's like what a human brain does know. I'll say like this. It is nothing but mimicking the operation of a human brain, right? Neural network is nothing but it is completely like human brain. So if you take our human brain, it is connected by number of neurons, and all these information is passed on to the neurons, and the information is processed and it is again sent back to the to its desired area. Similarly, a neural network works on that basis. We have number of neurons, we have an input layer, number of neurons that is connected, and we have an output layer, and all this will be, it is just a copy of human brain, guys. So neural network is an advanced version of machine learning. It's a little complicated, but not too complicated. And as it is complicated, it is the applications of deep learning is very huge. Example, as I told you, self-driven cars are complete examples of deep learning. Self-driven cars. NLP is a complete example of deep learning. NLP is nothing but, again, natural language processing. So, you know, neural networks are used when there is a lot of computation task has to be involved. Right, lot of computational task has to be involved. If you want to consider this, imagine if you want to drive a car without any driver, think how much amount of computation, how much amount of process of information has to be taken into input, process it, and given as an output. So it requires a large amount of resources, computational power, and everything. Right. So that is what your deep learning model will come in. So basically, your object detection. Even I came across an article recently. So using a deep learning model, an Indian startup has made a model, right? So what it will do now, from a gather from a crowd of people, we will be detecting their heat, the temperature, using a thermal camera, and that input will be taken. And that based upon that that temperature, whomever is having higher temperature, those guys will be taken out. They will be scanned, right? Their lungs will be scanned, and then these scanned images are fit into a neural network model, and this model will detect whether a person has coronavirus or not. And this model has given an accuracy of 96%, guys. Only 4% of accuracy has gone wrong. That means it is giving a 96% of accuracy. If a doctor is taking 2 days to identify whether a person has corona or not by looking at their scanned images and all other stuffs, a neural network in a matter of some 15 or 16 minutes, when you input a scanned image of a lung, it will say whether a guy has a corona disease or not. So a model has been built by startup, and it has been recognized so much. So these are some, and we can detect diabetics. We can detect, detect brain tumor. So these are some of the applications that is used in medical industry. So think of it like how vast is this application that is being used in every industries, right? So that is part, that is your deep learning part. Anyway, when you come into artificial intelligence is nothing but, everybody would have seen Terminator movie, Arnold, T-800. That guy, he's a robot, right? So that is what your artificial intelligence is. Artificial intelligence at high end is the T-Rex machines, T-800 machines, or not T-Rex, T-800 machines. So it's like at the high end of the artificial intelligence. It is a high layer of artificial intelligence. So basically what a human does, what are the activity a human does, if a computer is doing it in a very better way, in a shorter way, in a quicker way, that is called as your artificial intelligence. Your chatbot is an example of your artificial intelligence, right? So there should not be any customer care sitting on the other end and answering for your questions. So if you're giving a call to your customer care, and if a robot is answering to a question, that is called as artificial intelligence. So basically, this is the main difference between machine learning, deep learning, and artificial intelligence. And data science is the combination of everything, right? So data science will be included, machine learning will be included, deep learning will be included, artificial intelligence will be included, statistics, probability, your integration, differentiation, calculus, then your visualization tools. There are visualization tools such as Tableau and Power BI, and all those things. When these things are combined together, no? That is called as, this entire field is called as data science. So guys, this is a basic difference. I can tell you in a better way. So I'll go here, I'll create a new presentation. So consider like this, guys. Consider a pyramid. Okay, so sorry for the diagram. So at the bottom of your pyramid is your machine learning. On top of your pyramid lies your deep learning. And at the very bottom of your pyramid lies your artificial intelligence. And combining together is your data science. Along with your probability, your mathematical things, probability, statistics, and all of these things, right? So this is what your very basic introduction, okay? So I guess you guys are clear about it, right? Can I proceed? I'll proceed. I'll take the questions once after this, or everything is done. So as this industry is growing up so much now, there are multiple job opportunities that is available. So as a fresher, we know that data scientist role is like a hype that is created right now. Everybody says that I want to be a data scientist. I want to get into a data scientist. So how do we start my data science journey? So how do, you know, what is the shortest way to get into a data scientist role? And all of these questions are the common questions that I get on LinkedIn. So instead, my advice is like a fresher who is from college or who is studying in college or who is getting passed out from the college. A fresher should not focus on the job title. Instead, they should focus on their skills. And based upon what their skills they have, they can take their role accordingly. Right. So if you take the data industry altogether, this altogether industry is called as data industry. Okay, DI. So there are various job roles that is available in data industry. Suppose I'll say it is a data scientist, data analyst, business analyst, you know, data engineer, big data engineer, data architect, statistician, you know, big model engineer. So all of these jobs role is available. So I want you guys to understand your skill set, and based upon your skill set, decide the role that you have to take. Right. So on simple words, I'll tell you what these job roles are. Okay. So I've given a shorter name for this. So data scientist is like as rare as unicorns. Data analyst like data detective. Business analyst is like change agent. And big data engineer is jack of all trades. Data architect is data modeler. And the king, who is a data analytics manager, is a manager of this whole universe. So basically, I'll tell you what these guys do. Okay. So I'll do a diagram so that again you guys can understand it in a very good way. So there is a life cycle for data science project, guys. So you guys would have studied software development life cycle, right? So similarly, in an industry, there is a process called as data science life cycle, DSLC, data science life cycle. So basically, this is a process in which every stage will have separate kind of functions and operations that has to be done, right? So basically, we'll take it as a real-time example. We'll take a real-time example of predicting a diabetics, whether a person has diabetics or not. Right. So basically, a deep learning model can be used there. So you have a startup, you have a company. So you are going to a hospital and you are telling that person, going to the hospital MD and you are telling to that person like, sir, if you give me some amount of scanned images of the people who have diabetics, I have built a machine learning model which will basically tell whether the person has diabetics or not. Right. So this is the business problem. Okay. So this is your first stage. I'll take a notepad. So this is your first stage, understanding a business problem. This is the first stage, guys. We should understand the business problem. The business problem here is like, we want to identify whether a person has diabetics or not. So that is your first step of us. Did not mention anything. Data science life cycle. Okay. So that is the first point, understanding a business problem. Once you understood your business problem, next you will be gathering the data. So gathering the data is like, you are going to prepare biryani for your home today, right? So before preparing biryani, you need to go and purchase items, right? So that is what also implies here. It's like you want to go get your biryani rice, you want to go get some kind of vegetables and all those stuff, oil and all those stuff. So basically, I'm applying the same concept here. Once you want to gather the data on basis of what your business problem is, you need to understand the business problem. Once every business problem is understood, you will be gathering the data. So gathering the data in our scenario, it will be like getting scanned images, right? Getting scanned image, then getting the hospital details, right? Getting hospital details, then what else you can get? You can get the patient details, very, very important patient details, then their glucose level, then include insulin level and all those and all those things, right? So that is your gathering your data. So that is your second step. Third step is pre-processing your data. What in this step you will do is, you will be, okay, all your computer will be understanding ones and zeros, correct? All the, but whatever we have, whatever it is human understandable form, it is not understood by a computer. So we need to convert that into a format of ones and zeros, right? So this process is taken care here. We are making the data to be ready for a machine learning model. That can be fetched, FPETCHD, into a machine or a computer. Perfect. So once after pre-processing is done, you will be building a model. So basically, this is the interesting part. You will be predicting the things, whatever you want to predict, right? So you will be predicting the steps, things. So under our business scenario, I mean, under our condition, our example, so we got the scanned images and everything. We got the hospital details. Then we'll collect the data, we'll put into Python, we'll convert into a way of ones and zeros, and we will be putting that into the machine. The machine will understand the data, it will understand the patterns of the data, and it will predict the value, whether on the basis of the patterns that is given by the input, given in the input, it predicts the things, whether a person has a diabetes or not, right? So once after prediction, it is deployed into production in the sense, it is given to the public, or it is given to the real-time environment. A real-time data will be coming into this particular model, and this model will process the data, and all this, again, from the starting, all these things will happen. Again, this is the basic overview of DSLC, data science lifecycle, right? So this is a basic, very basic thing. Inside this, some more process will be taken. If interested, we can get into that also. So this is a basic thing. So here is the thing where the job role of a different engineer will come up. For example, understanding a business problem. This is basically done by a business analyst, right? A business analyst is the guy. Okay, now guys, I want you to listen keenly, because this is the area where you guys can select your role accordingly, right? If you wanted to get into the field of data science, this is the area that you want to, you know, keenly observe what the stuff is. So starting with business analysts are the guys who have very good communication skill, who can present the things in a very good way to the stakeholders in the sense, you will be the presenter, actually, right? You will be the presenter, you will be presenting it to someone. The main role of a business analyst will be like gathering, you have to talk to the company owners. You need to understand what the company exactly, you need to understand the problem, business problem. Once after you understand the business problem, you have to convert it into a way which will be understood by other guys, right? So that is what a business analyst does. So your business analyst main important skills is communication is very important. He should be good at one of these skills, visualization tool such as Tableau. We have some visualization tool called as Tableau or Power BI. Okay, both of these are very powerful tools. Tableau. Okay, Tableau or Power BI. Both of these tools are very very highly licensed tools. It is not affordable for students, right? But having a knowledge of this Tableau or Power BI, it will be a very good advantage, because it will allow you to create brilliant dashboards. You know, the dashboards which will be created in Tableau is like awesome. It will be very presentive. It can be presented in a very good way. You know, you will have the dashboards that can be created using these tools will be very good. Actually, it's just drag and drop. There is no need of coding at all. It's just kind of drag and drop, and it's like that. So yeah, So that is what your business analyst is. Next one is gathering the data. So this is basically done by a data engineer. Okay, guys. So data engineer, the main purpose of the data engineer is, you know, okay. First of all, the data is collected in different way, guys. Primary source, secondary source, tertiary source. So primary source is like you will be directly going to the hospital and taking the stuff from them, taking the data from them. That is the primary way. Secondary way is like the data will be stored into a database container, ETL tools, into a database container. Using the ETL tools like extraction, transformation, and loading, you will be abstracting or you will be taking those data and then you will be converting it into such a way that can be processed into a machine. So that is what your data engineer does. So step two and step three is completely covered by a data engineer.
Sachin, sorry for the interruption. Are you typing something in your notepad?
Yes, sir.
It is not visible. It is not visible to us.
Oh, is it? Okay.
Okay.
One second, sir. Let me check what it is. Okay, let me stop the sharing and I'll share it again. I think it is because of some internet issue. So can you confirm, is it visible now?
Yeah, now it's okay.
Okay, perfect. So guys, sorry for that. now it is better, right?
Yeah, it's now okay. Okay.
Okay. So I was discussing on this part, guys, gathering on the data. Okay. So gathering the data and pre-processing your data is done by data engineer. So data engineer should have the skills that is necessary for a data engineer is first, he should have knowledge of database applications like MySQL, SQL and all those stuff, or Active Databases and all those stuff. He should have knowledge on that. ETL, basic ETL tools like Hive, Spark, and all those things. And then he should be able to clean the data, pre-process the data. For that, he should be knowing either Python or R. Okay, so this is what a data engineer does. Okay, data engineer is doing this. And a data analyst, what does a data analyst is? What does a data analyst do is? I'll write it here. Okay. Again, a data engineer collects the data. He changes the pattern of the data because some of the data that is getting from the real-time industry, it will be like unstructured data. So a data engineer will get the data from in an unstructured format and he'll convert into a format which can be, pre-processed, which can be programmed in such a way that it can be fed into a machine learning model. So a data analyst will be coming into that particular role. So basically a data analyst will be cleaning the data. Pre-processing the data is done mainly by a data analyst. So what are the skills that is needed for a data analyst is, again, he should be very good at either R or Python. But guys, Python is preferred across all the industries because it is an open source. Even R is also an open source, but Python is preferred across in almost all the industries because of the, because it is an open community, a lot of things is available in Python. Okay, it's like an ocean. So if you have any doubt in Python, you just go Google it, you will get the answer. It's as simple as that. And Python is very easy to learn also. So a data analyst should be very good at either R or Python. You should have good communication skill. This is what a data analyst is. We'll revise what we have done. So the data will be collected by a business analyst. The business analyst will change it into a format and it will go to a data engineer. The data engineer will pre-process the data. He'll convert into a way which can be fed into a machine learning model. Again, a data analyst will come in. He'll convert into a way which can be, he'll try to find out some things. It's called as EDA, exploratory data analysis. Okay, it's kind of, it's a small inner depth concept, EDA, exploratory data analysis. So the basic job of a data analyst is exploratory data analysis. exploratory data analysis. So this is basically, guys, exploratory data analysis is like, how do I say, it's like before driving or starting your car engine. So that is what your exploratory data analysis is. Without EDA, if you go and build your model, no, it'll be like starting a bike without petrol. So it's like that. So I hope you are understanding the similarity between the two. So it is very important to do exploratory data analysis. Again, it is a deeper concept. I am not getting into that. So EDA part is done by a data analyst. So he should be very good at coding. Coding is very important. Coding skill is very important. Perfect. Next part, the most interesting part is the model building, the prediction thing. So this is done by a data scientist. And data scientist not only predict the model, he'll be doing all these steps also. So right from the first step, again, he'll go back to that step. He'll re-verify that. Again, he'll go to what a data engineer does. He'll re-verify that. Again, he'll go to what a data analyst does. He'll go back to that. He'll check it. He'll verify everything. Then he'll build a model and he'll predict the things. And also sometimes he deploys the model, right? So this is what your basic data science lifecycle goes on. So these are the different roles that is available, guys. So data scientists should have skills on coding, either R or Python. You should be having knowledge and visualization tools like Python, like Tableau or Power BI. You should be knowing stats. Stats is nothing but statistics. You should be knowing probability. And very importantly, you should have an excellent communication skill. Because he is the guy going to take the presentation to the stakeholders, right? So these are some important roles that is available, and these are the basic differences of these roles. Many people will go directly jump into, I want to get into a data scientist, but without knowing what are the things that is currently, or what are the things that is inside it. So I hope you guys have understood about this, okay? These are the different job opportunities that is available. So basically, these presentations is nothing but, again, what I told is like, here it is. So you guys can just go through this. So role of a data scientist will be, he should be knowing R. SAS is another tool, but its license is so heavy. Industry stopped using it because of its license. So on replacement of SAS, we have started using Python and R. But Python is most preferred. Similarly, MATLAB is not important right now. SQL, Hive, Spark, and all those things. All these are other tools. What are the talents he should have? He should have good computing skills, which is nothing but your coding skills. Predictive modeling. Predictive modeling is again nothing but building a model, building a machine learning model. So there are various machine learning models, guys. There are linear regression, logistic regression. As I told earlier, you know, we'll get into those details later. Storytelling, visualization. As I told, max stats and machine learning. So this is what a data scientist does. So he cleans, massages, and organizes a very big data. So his mindset will be like he's a curious data wizard. His mindset will be like every day you'll not be in IT industry. Most of the people will be doing the same stuff, repeating again and again and again and again, and it goes on like that. But if you take a role of a data scientist, no, it is never like that. You see data, you'll be learning something new every day, right? So it's like, and learning is a never-ending process. No, you will keep learning every day. It's like you feel interesting to work, actually. So it's like quite interesting to work on. And most of the companies that hire is like big companies like Google, Microsoft, and Adobe, right? So if you move on to a data analyst, these are the roles and responsibilities a data analyst does. So again, he collects, processes, and performs the statistical data analysis. This will be his mindset. He'll be like an intuitive data junkie with high figure out quotient. He wanted to figure out what is there inside the data. I want to find some patterns from the data. I want to find the findings from the data, you know, those things. The people who have that, I want to find out something new. Those kind of mentality people can get into this role, actually, data analyst. So these are the language that should be known, R, Python. Ignore these guys, HTML, JavaScript, C, C++, SQL. SQL is needed. HTML, JavaScript and all is not needed, actually. So Excel part is also known. Excel is an added advantage. Again, SQL you should know. Communication is very important. And max stats, machine learning. Moving on to a data engineer, the one who collects the data from the databases things. So yeah, his role is like develops and construct, test and maintain architectures, just databases and processing systems. his mindset will be like all purpose every man. So these are some of the talents, skills he should have. He should know data modeling, ETL tools, what I told is like extraction, transformation, and loading tools, like Hive, Spark, and all those things. Spark, Perl, and all, right? And database systems. So this is what a data engineer does. Next one is data architect. Data architect is like the architect. He should have all the skills. He's similar to a data scientist. So data architect is similar to a data scientist. So all the things that has been covered previously, you know, will be covered under a data architect. Business analyst, what is that? Is like gathering the data and all those steps. So he should be very, he should have very good communication skill. He should know MS Office because he's the one going to the stakeholders and gathering the data. And he should have listening skills, good storytelling, telling things. You know, he should know business intelligence and all those stuff. And his role will be improve the business process and intermediary business between the business and IT. So he will be a bridge between IT and the business. This is the kingmaker, data analytics manager. He's the entire team manager. It's like these people will be like a 10 or 15 years of experience. These guys are like kingmaker guys. He will be the, once everything is done, he's the person who verifies everything. He is like our college principal. He who decides everything, right? So that is the purpose of, he is called as DAM, data analytics manager. So guys, these are some of the packages that has been given by Glassdoor company. These are the yearly packages. So just have a look at it. This is completely to the data relevant industry. So if you see here, this is an annual package. So data analyst, business analyst, business analyst, business intelligence analyst, business intelligence consultant, business intelligence developer are a part of or a subsection of these business analysts. Again, data engineer, we have discussed. Business intelligence architect is again a sub-branch of business analyst. Next one is data architect. Data architect is what we have discussed earlier. Again, business intelligence manager is again a sub-branch of business intelligence analyst. Those are senior folks. And again, the topmost position is data scientist. You guys can Google it actually. What is the hottest job of 21st century? It is called as data scientist. So that is why a lot of hype has been going around for this industry, right? So this is it guys. So if you guys are interested to learn this, a long story short, the main purpose of doing this lecture is for you guys to, you know, there are industries opening, there are many job openings that is available in the field of data science, but I don't want the kids from IITs and NITs to learn everything and get into a well-paid jobs. I want you guys also, because I know there are a lot of talented people sitting down there and listening to my lecture. Fortunately, I had the opportunity to learn something I like so much, and I worked hard, and it's like I got into a data scientist role. So I want, and I'm not from IITs and NIT, okay? I also passed out from a secondary college. So I want you guys, you know, to come up to learn these stuffs and get ready in such a way that when industry comes in, they should be ready to hire you. Okay, so that is the main reason I'm doing this lecture. It's like I'm filling the gap between an industry and a college. So there are, I know there are a lot of placements going on, but again, you should be changed in such a way that once you get, you know, a company comes into your college, the recruitment should be impressed on seeing your resume. Because I used to take college interviews, and I used to see students, and I used to look at their resumes also. So it's like I want you students to, you know, get to know about this latest technology that is going on, guys. So that once you get learn about this, you know, get passed among this, then you will be able to know what it is actually. So that is the main reason I'm doing this section. So if you guys are really interested, I can offer you a class also. So the plan is like, I'll explain your plan, what it is. I'll make it very simple. So I, along with a training school called as Firebase, so we have planned a setup like this. The plan is like, it will contain three process, stage one, stage two, and stage three. Okay. Stage one, stage 2 and stage 3. So stage 1 will be, guys, whomever after this webinar, whomsoever is interested, we will be giving you a Google form. You can if interested, you guys can fill the form, right? Once the form is filled, what you have to do is, we will be on the basis of the registered email ID, we will be giving you content of data science. Data science in this sense, we will be giving you 15 hours of pre-recorded video, which contains Python concepts. Okay, so this has been given by a company called as Fireblaze AI School. So it's like he was my mentor. So I discussed about this to him. So he offered, like, I'll give you some contents to those guys. Those guys can learn and come back to us. So that is the idea he gave me. So that is how this idea came pitched in. So yeah, coming back to the topic. So first 15 hours of your video will be containing fully Python based concepts. Okay, guys, fully Python. It will be based on NumPy, Panda, Matplotlib, Seaborn. These are some of the packages that is used in data science. Okay, so it will be having 15 hours of video, pre-recorded video. We will be giving you 15 days of time. Once your 15 days of time is done, we will be keeping a small test for you guys. Okay, so once the students who clears the first round now will be passed on to the second stage. Second stage is like, we will be giving industry relevant knowledge, because I'll tell you, there are a lot of platforms to learn data science. There are a lot of websites to learn data science, but people doesn't know where to start and where to go and all those tips. So me, along with that guy, his name is Aniruddha Kalbande. So he's the founder of Firebase company. So myself and Aniruddha will be taking live classes for 10 to 12 days or 7 to 10 days based upon the topics that we are going to cover. We will be giving the industry relevant examples. So I spoke about the machine learning models such as linear regression, logistic regression, neural networks, and all those stuff, right? So all those we will be covering it here. Okay, so he is an industry expert, I am an industry expert. So we will be telling what are the concepts that is covered in industry right now. That session will be like 7 to 12 days, every day 1 hour of session, right? So once that is done, again, a test will be conducted, and persons and students who's clearing that particular round will be moved to stage 3. On the stage 3, what we do is, we are planning to give communication training, and we are planning for soft skill training also, and most beneficially, an internship opportunity for very good, for people who are doing very well. Because this company, I think it has been founded in the year 2017, I guess. It's been 3 years they have been doing it. So they have tie up with many companies, guys. This company has tie up with many companies. So once an exceptionally good guy is doing this, we will be giving an internship opportunity to these guys. Okay. And everything. Yeah. And what we are planning is, like, to cover all these stages, we are charging 800 per student. Okay. So you guys can think of it. What are the concepts that we are covering? And you can go to your any online courses, check how much prices they are getting, because the main reason I want to do this for free, but the main reason we are charging 800, which is a very, very less cost, I think, is because the main reason I want you guys to come up. That is the main reason. And second thing, if we are giving it free of cost, no, you guys will not be having a responsibility of doing it, because that is how it happened last week in my college. So I don't want to, because I have a lot of work, I want to do it. I'm wasting my, I'm keeping my company work and I'm giving a lecture to you guys. It means that I'm putting out something, right? So if you guys are really interested, I want guys who are really interested to come into this. Yes, we will be giving you a very good amount of training. We will be making you relevant. Just giving back to the society, guys, nothing else. So this is the plan we have made. This is for the final year students, right? This is for the fourth year students. For the third year students, what we are planning is, like, this is for fourth year. For third year students, what we are planning is, the stage 1 and stage 2 will be common. For stage 3, the process will be like, we will be forming a community. Okay, community 1 from your college, Universal Engineering College. And if you're conducting webinar in the second college, there will be another community formed in that college. Another some college, and there will be hackathons, there will be meetups and all those competitions related to data science that will be conducted along the colleges. So that, again, we are trying to make you to improve your skills. So it's think of it, guys. So it's a benefit for you guys as well as for me. A Google form will be given at the end of the session so that interested guys can come and pitch in and other process will be done. All right. And yeah, that's it. My session, I'll finish off the session. So yeah, so that's it, guys. So this is an open, it's a question answer forum. You can ask any type of questions right now. We can clear it up.
Thank you, sir. Now we will go ahead and take
so guys, I hope everybody please.
Okay, thank you, sir. We will go ahead and take some time for questions now. Just a reminder, please be sure to type your questions into the question box, or you have the option of raise hand in control panel for asking your doubts. All the participants, please make sure you have this time for asking your questions.
And guys, to add up on that, no, you can type any type of questions for that. No, even if it is silly, it's okay, because I know I have gone through your stage. I know how it feels to ask questions, but that's okay. As a senior folks telling you guys, you can ask me any questions. I'm open to answer.
Excuse me, sir, there's a question in the YouTube live. That question is from Prayag Devdas. So can you please say more about symbolic learning?
Symbolic learning?
Yeah, he have asked that question.
What is it, symbolic learning? I am not sure what is it, symbolic learning. I'm hearing it for the first time. I'm not sure about that. Whose name is that? What was his name?
Prayag Devdas.
Prayag Devdas, I'm not sure what it is exactly. I'm sorry for that. I'm hearing it for the first time, actually. Symbolic learning, I'm hearing it for the first time. I'm sorry, I don't know that.
Okay, sir. Another question is from Aloysius Anthony. The question is whether Python or R language is easy to learn.
Always Python is very easy to learn, because I'll tell you, the syntax in Python, if you compare C++ and Python, no, Python is like very easy, because in C you have to put syntax and all those stuff. In Python, there is no kind of syntax and all those things. It's very easy to learn. Python is very, very easy to learn. And if you don't have the programming knowledge itself, if you get started with Python, it will be very easy to learn. It's not difficult. And if you come into R, R is easy also, but it's quite complicated, little complicated. But I don't prefer you to learn R. I would prefer you to start with Python every day. Perfect. Does that answer your question, Aloysius? Okay, I think what happened, ma'am? Is there any other questions or what is it happening?
No, sir. Thank you, sir. That's all about in the YouTube live section.
Okay, perfect. Guys, come on, college students. I want someone to, ask questions for me. What happened? Young minds, come on. What are you guys doing? Guys, this is your time to ask questions. Don't, sit there. Just ask questions, whatever type of question it is, just shoot it out. I can tell you.
Participants, please use this time for asking your questions.
Okay, what I can understand from here is, like, if the questions are not coming, either students would have understood everything or the students did not understand anything. Any of these two cases would have happened.
I think they got a clear idea about the topic.
Great.
Okay, it's look like we have covered all of our questions. Thank you, sir. We can conclude now. On behalf of Universal Engineering College, I would like to express our profound gratitude to the presenter of our first day webinar series, Sajin Madhavan. Thank you very much for making the webinar with our participants a really successful one. We greatly appreciate the presentation you gave to us. It was nothing short of incredibly informative and interesting. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much.
And also, okay. And also, I express our sincere gratitude to our principal, Dr. Jose K. Jacob, and our HOD, Sanal Kumar, sir. I am happy to express vote of thanks to our staff members who have made this webinar a grand success. Once again, thank you, everyone. We appreciate you being here. I would like to request you all to fill the feedback form that we have sent in your YouTube chat box and also in your registered email ID. It will be considered as your attendance sheet. Okay, now I would like to remind about tomorrow's webinar. We will have Mr. Sudhiran Mohanan on the topic Enterprise, Digital Transformation and Emerging Technologies. Thanks once again for joining us today and we will see you next time. Stay safe and stay healthy. Thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you all.